So this, on this video, you can review. Hey guys, we're filming. On this video, you can review this sheet. So as I'm talking, you'll be looking at this picture of the back muscles. So let's review the muscles. The sternocleidomastoid is that those two muscles you see along the front of your neck. Their job is to help turn and lift the head. If you're lying on your back, obviously both of them can flex together to help lift your head. If you're standing up straight, when one muscle flexes, it'll turn your head to one side. Because it reaches around the corner, you can see the sternocleidomastoid connects to what's called the mastoid process, that bump of bone behind your ear. So that muscle was named according to its insertion and its origins. The seventh cervical vertebra is not a muscle, but it's a good landmark to tell where a lot of other structures are. It's the lowest vertebra on the neck. There are seven cervical vertebrae, 12 thoracic vertebrae, meaning vertebrae that have ribs on them, and then there's 5 lumbar vertebrae, and I forget the number of sacral vertebrae. I think it might be 5 or 7. They're all fused, so it's one big lump of bone. The deltoid is on the side. It lifts the arm. If you have the medial head, there's 3 heads on the deltoid, really, and it's called the deltoid because it's shaped like a triangle, like the Greek letter delta. And the function of the deltoid is to lift the arm. Depending on which head is flexing, the arm will go different ways. So anterior head will lift the arm forward, the side delt will raise the arm to the side, and the rear delt tends to do this. Teres minor and major help to rotate the arm outwardly. They're part of the rotator cuff series, if I'm not mistaken. Then there's the triceps, which straightens the arm. The triceps also bridges the gap from your humerus to your shoulder blade with one of the heads, so it also helps to pull the arm down. The latissimus dorsi muscle is the muscle that helps you row when you pull your arms back, or if you're doing a chin-up, it helps to pull the arms down. It's a large fan-shaped muscle at the back. Number 8 is the external oblique, which is right over here. It stabilizes the torso, so if you're going side to side, it'll also stretch. Gluteus maximus is the biggest muscle in the body, and its job is to push the leg back. You use it especially when you're climbing stairs. If you take two stairs at a time, it'll really stretch the gluteus. The semitendinosus, the biceps femoris, and the semimembranosus are the hamstring muscles, and their job is to bend the leg and to extend the hip. So when you lean forward with your legs straight, your hamstring muscles help to stabilize the hip from tilting too far forward. So if you ever want to exercise this group of 3 muscles, one of the ways to do it is to pull the weight up from the ground with the legs straight. The gastrocnemius is the heart-shaped calf muscle. It helps to point the toes. The peroneus longus and brevis they help to avert and stabilize the foot. So if you're running around a corner, they're the muscles that prevent you from turning your ankle over. Splenius capitis is the muscle that raises the head. If you're leaning forward, it's the muscle that helps you raise your head off the pillow if you're sleeping on your stomach. Trapezius muscles do this and this. So they help to pull the shoulders up and back. So they help to pull the shoulder blades. It's a large muscle. Some of it is above the shoulder blades, and a lot of the mass of the trapezius muscle is between the shoulder blades. The infraspinatus is a large triangle-shaped muscle it's a small triangle-shaped muscle, but it covers most of the shoulder blade, and it helps to rotate the arm, and it also stabilizes the shoulder so that you can, the larger muscles can do their job. A portion of the rhomboids that's visible in that picture, the rhomboids are strap-like muscles that connect the middle of the spine and the shoulder blade, and they help to pull the shoulder blades up and inwards. Extensors of the wrist and fingers help you to do this and this. The adductor magnus is the biggest muscle in the group called the adductors, and the adductors help to pull your legs together. They also, of course, help you, they stabilize you when you're walking. If you didn't have your adductors, your legs would tend to sort of spread apart as you were walking, and that wouldn't work very well. The gracilis muscle is a very thin muscle that probably functions to give only a kinesthetic sense. It doesn't actually do any real work because it's pencil thin, but it probably sends information to the brain about where your leg is. The iliotibial tract is the muscles on the side of the leg. Actually, it's not a muscle here. The muscle is up here, tensor fascia lata. And then the iliotibial tract is the tendon that goes down the side and connects to the knee to help lift the leg upwards. The plantaris muscle imitates the function of the gastrocnemius, but it's a very tiny muscle, probably has a similar function to the gracilis in the sense that it acts more like a sensor than as a prime mover. It's a very tiny muscle, but it probably sends information to the brain about where your leg is and what it's doing. Gastrocnemius tendon is the big long tendon, also known as the Achilles heel. It connects the gastrocnemius to the heel. And the last two things are the soleus, which has a similar function to the gastrocnemius, but it has the added function of helping to bend the leg. And the last thing is the superior peroneal retinaculum, which is a band of tissue that holds the tendons close to your ankle. That's it. For the back muscles.